Good afternoon, gardeners. It's Tuesday, April 20th, and it's a beautiful afternoon here on the southeastern coast of North Carolina. And today I'm going to show you all the best way I have found, and I've tried all of the methods, the best way that I have found to support indeterminate tomato plants, and that is the string trellising method. When most people think of a tomato plant, they think of the classic indeterminate tomato plant, which is a vine. And indeterminate tomatoes are liable to grow anywhere from 6 to 8 feet or longer in a single season. And as such, they demand a lot of support. Now, normally they would grow all over the ground in their wild climate, but these much sweeter and more productive varieties that we've bred over the years have become very susceptible to pests and diseases, and they tend to get attacked when they crawl all over the ground. So we like to support them and grow them vertically because that keeps the pests off of them and it promotes better airflow to reduce disease. Now, I've tried all of the different methods of supporting tomatoes, from cages to stakes to trellising and Florida weave, and while they all are good at different things, when it comes to the indeterminate tomatoes, this string trellis method is by far the best and most efficient way that I've found to grow them. Now, last year I expanded my garden, and in that garden expansion I built tomato trellises all throughout my garden, and I will make sure to link that video above where I showed you all how to build those tomato trellises. So if you do not have a trellis for your garden, I provided several different ways for you to build those trellises, so make sure you watch that if you need to build a trellis. This video I want to simplify, and I just want to show you how to support them once you already have the trellis and why it's the best method of supporting indeterminate tomatoes. There are three major reasons why I love the string trellising method of supporting indeterminate tomatoes, and they are ease, versatility, and strength. Once you build your initial trellis, it is very easy to support all of your tomatoes. Everything that you need is right here in this bin, and to buy these supplies, I have them all linked in my Amazon storefront in the video description. These are all really, really cheap supplies. The first thing that you'll need is one of these double tomato hooks. These hooks come in 10 packs, and they contain this synthetic twine that will not expand and shrink with the changing temperatures and with wetness and humidity, and you will use one of these to support each tomato main stem. Then, in order to support the tomato main stems, all you have to do is buy these tomato clips, which are incredibly cheap, and that clips on to the twine I just showed you, and then the clip goes around the neck of the tomato itself, and that will be your support. The next reason why I love these string trellises is the strength is just incredible. And I know what you're thinking, how can this little string provide a whole lot of strength? Well, it's actually simpler than you may think. If you are tying your tomatoes to some kind of hard trellis, like a fence panel like this, or a traditional tomato stake, what happens is when the wind blows up against the tomato, it doesn't move. The tomato has to absorb all that wind force. But with these string trellises, they actually deflect the force of the wind, and they bend with the wind, they sway, so they don't take the full front of the wind. And we get a lot of tropical storms here on the southeastern coast of North Carolina, a lot of hurricanes, and it is shocking how when we have 30, 40 mile an hour winds, how these tomato plants are barely moving. And that's because the strings just sway in harmony with the wind, so they don't take the full brunt of the force. Now, last year we got a direct hit from Hurricane Isaias. I only lived 9 miles inland, and the eye of the storm came on shore about 20 miles from my house in my county. We were in the direct southeastern eye wall, which is the worst place to be. We must have been getting 80 to 90 mile an hour winds, and none of my tomatoes sustained any damage despite hurricane force. And that is because all I had to do was, the day before the hurricane, was I just had to take my string, and then I could take my tomatoes and I could just lie them on the ground like this. And then I put a tarp over them and a couple of bricks on the tarp just to cover them all up. And then the next day I pulled the tarps up and I simply grabbed my hook, and just like that, I stood them all back up, and that's all I had to do. And this, I was also able to extend my season doing this to miss the first few frosts once November came around, and I was able to maintain my tomatoes all the way into December simply by placing them against the ground when the frost came. So these trellises are incredibly versatile because you can pick them up and you can put them back down as you wish. And that brings me to my third and final reason why string trellising is the best method of growing indeterminate tomatoes, and that is versatility. What you see in front of you is a standard indeterminate tomato plant, and the anatomy of the tomato plant is as follows. Here, underneath the roots, you have the main stem that grows up from the roots. As you follow the main stem of the tomato, you will come to a node. And at each node, you will find two things. You will find at roughly 90 degrees from the main stem, you will find a leaf node. And this is where the leaves of the tomato plant come into play. The leaves are the solar panels of the tomato. Their job is to collect sunlight and via photosynthesis convert sunlight into energy for the plant. And then coming off at a 45 degree angle here, that is called a sucker. And each of these suckers have the capability of becoming a new main stem. And if you let these suckers grow, they will become equal in size and productivity to the original main stem of the tomato plant. Here you can see what happens to a tomato plant if you do not prune off the suckers. Originally, at the base here, was the original main stem of the plant, but then I let these suckers grow out at the nodes. So now I have a sucker going out this way, I have a sucker growing out this way, and I have a sucker growing out this way. And these are a cherry tomato type, and cherry tomatoes tend to put out a tremendous number of suckers. And you'll see on each of these main stems, what happens after the node is you get a flower cluster. So obviously the flowers are potential tomatoes, so you'll see the more main stems you'll have, the more opportunities you will have for flower clusters. So by that logic, it's the best to have as many main stems as possible, right? Wrong. It's not necessarily in your best interest to have as many main stems as possible, because at the end of the day, the roots can only support so much energy going to the tomato plant. So the more main stems you allow to grow, the smaller your fruits will be and potentially lower quality. So you have to strike a balance between the ideal number of main stems. Now, with more traditional methods of tying tomatoes like staking, it makes it very hard to support a whole bunch of different main stems because each main stem needs its own stake. So it can be a ton of work and the stakes can get weighed down and broken. The nice thing about the string trellising method is all you have to do is just add another tomato hook. So you can support an unlimited number of main stems. So what I've found over the years is the ideal number of main stems for most indeterminate tomato plants to have are 2 or 3 main stems. That usually gives you ample amount of fruit, but it also controls the energy enough that you're not going to get really small tomatoes. So you will still get good fruit size with 2 to 3 main stems. The exception to that rule will be the cherry tomatoes. Because the cherry tomatoes have such small fruits, generally it's best to just let them vine out as much as possible because it doesn't take a lot of energy to make a cherry tomato. Now, before we get started, I want to show you how to clean up your tomato plant with pruning in order to get it ready for string trellising. The first thing I recommend is the removal of all of the green growth below the first few flower clusters. And that's because all of the green growth below the first few flowers is good for nothing really but contracting diseases. What happens is when it rains or when you water, soil-borne pathogens splash onto the undersides of the leaves, and that is how you get disease. So I'm going to take a clean pair of shears and I'm going to remove all of the suckers like this. That's a sucker. And then I'm going to remove all of these leaf nodes, and I'm going to take them all away to that very first flower cluster. And that right there just opened up a ton of airflow to my tomato plant. So now all of the leaves below the flower clusters have been removed, so I'm only dealing here with 2 main stems. And this right here was the original main stem, and then this right here was a sucker that came off the main stem. So now I have 2 main stems. So in order to support them, we are going to need 2 tomato hooks. So now all I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 tomato hooks, 1 for each main stem, and I'm going to unravel about 6 or 7 feet worth of the twine, because my trellis is about 7 feet tall. That will just about reach the bottom of the tomato plant. So that will grab 1 main stem. And that's long enough for the second tomato main stem. Now let me show you how the tomato clips work, because it's really ingenious. All you have to do is bring the twine over to the main stem of the plant that you want to support, and then there's this rough patch inside of the clip that has a gap. You just put that gap up against the twine, you close it right around it, and then you take the clip and you put it right underneath one of those leaf nodes for support, and then you close it and that clips on, and if any wind blows, that will hold the plant in place. Now let's do it for the second main stem. I'm going to place the clip right around the twine. It needs to be a little bit lower. Sometimes you get it a little bit too high up. And then you can place it right underneath the node once again, and that will clip right on. Now sometimes when you clip it on, it will be a little bit looser than you want it to be. And if you find that your tomato clips are a little bit looser than you want them to be, and there's not enough slack here, this one's pretty tight, but this one's pretty loose, all you really need to do is you just need to loop the twine just a little bit around the tomato hook, and that will pull more tension into the line. And just like that, you'll be able to provide more support to your tomato plant. So now our tomato plant is secured, and it's pretty tight. It's not going anywhere. It will hold up to some strong winds, but perhaps the greatest thing about this trellising system is that you can basically grow your tomato plants to a theoretical unlimited height. There is over 20 feet of string on these double tomato hooks. So if I wanted to, I could support a 20-foot tall tomato plant. And let me show you how that's possible. So imagine this tomato plant trellised all the way up to the top here. Well, all you would have to do is take this tomato plant hook off, and then you could unwrap it and you could add another foot or two of trellis, and then you could put it back up there. Now my tomato plant, the top is going to be lowered to here, and this part of the tomato plant will basically be lying on the ground. So what you can do is you can simply just remove all of the leaves and just curl and coil the vine up on the ground, and then you'll have another couple of feet for the tomato plant to trellis. And this is how they grow them in commercial greenhouses, and since they're usually protected from pests and diseases in greenhouses, they can become 20 feet tall or longer. So when you use this method, generally, your plants will never outgrow the trellis itself because the ceiling is basically unlimited. And there were several instances last year where my tomato plants got larger than the trellis, and I had to do this. I had to unravel them to make more room, drop the tops down to here, and that instantly gave myself more room for the plants to grow up. This is a huge advantage over stakes and wire trellises because they can't get any taller. And once the tomato plants reach the top, you're going to have to top all of your tomatoes because you're going to run out of infrastructure. Well, here, the infrastructure is only limited to the size of the twine. And you could add 20, 30 feet of twine to this if you wanted to. So now we will do another example with this cherry tomato. We'll take our twine, put the clip around it, pick up our cherry tomato, place the clip underneath one of the nodes, and this is such a big plant, it looks like we may need a second clip for support. So we'll take the second clip and we'll put that on right here. Now we will remove some of the lower growth so it doesn't drag on the ground. And that right there is a beautifully supported cherry tomato that's really starting to load up with some fruit. And now you can see what everything looks like individually staked up with tomato hooks. And bear in mind, this only took me about 30 minutes to do my entire garden. And that is how you support your indeterminate tomato plants with what I believe is the best method of supporting them that there is. So everybody, I sure hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please make sure to hit that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please subscribe for future updates and more videos like these. If you're curious about any of the products that I used in this video or to build my trellis or that I use in my garden in general, they are all linked in my Amazon storefront in the video description. Thank you all again so much for watching, and I hope to see all of you again on the next video.
Did you take it?
Dale, can I see the ball? Can I see the ball? Dale, drop. Good boy, Dale. That was excellent. Ready, buddy? Whoa! Go get it, Dale.